I'm Deborah Borchardt, and this is your Marijuana Money Minute. You may recall a couple of weeks ago, IANTHA said its shareholders approved of a recapitalization plan that effectively dropped the shareholders' ownership to less than 3% of the company. One group fought back, and as a result, the judge in the case didn't approve of the plan and bumped IANTHA's over to what's considered bankruptcy court in Canada, the CCCA. Jushi Holdings announced rising revenue after releasing preliminary financial results. The company is now estimating revenue of $24 million for its third quarter that ended in September. That's a change from its previous guidance in a range of $22 to $25 million, and it's a sequential increase of 61%. The guidance for revenue in the fourth quarter is now expected to be at the high end of their previous range of $25 to $30 million, and they also said that they expect to report positive adjusted EBITDA. The Green Organic Dutchman has entered into an agreement with Canaccord Genuity to purchase, on a bought deal basis, 46 some odd million units, and they're going to get about $11 million Canadian on that. Slang Worldwide is buying Colorado-licensed cannabis cultivator Pleasant Valley Ranch as the company makes another move to own part of its supply chain. Aurora Cannabis stock dropped this week after they announced that their activist investor, Nelson Peltz, had resigned as a senior advisor. MedFarm Holdings said it would not be extending their deal with Schwazze, formerly known as Medicine Men Technologies. This is the second company in 2 months to walk away from Schwazze, as in August, Medicine Man Denver also chose to part ways. Canadian mushroom company Optimi Health closed on an oversubscribed non-broker private placement of $4.4 million. We have a couple of stock moves to go over this week. C21 Investments has qualified to trade on the OTCQX Best Market, and Acquired Sales has been approved for trading on the OTCQB Venture Market. And that's it for this week. I'm Deborah Borchardt reporting for the Green Market Report.